As for the U.S., it says it continues to work with other U.N. Security Council members to resolve outstanding issues on the draft resolution. The White House says Washington fully supports addressing the humanitarian needs of Palestinians, but it insists details of the text matter. The U.S. wants to tone down the language of the resolution. An initial draft called for an urgent and lasting cessation of hostilities to allow unimpeded access of humanitarian aid to the Gaza Strip. But sources say it has been watered down to an urgent suspension of hostilities to satisfy Washington. Tense negotiations continue at the United Nations over a draft resolution on the Israel-Hamas war. The UN Security Council is avoiding another veto from the U.S. to pass a resolution drafted by the United Arab Emirates, which aims to allow more aid to enter Gaza. It also seeks a monitoring of the humanitarian assistance being delivered to the enclave.
We are now coming to the end of what was the deadliest year in the occupied Palestinian territory. This should be a wake-up call that the current status quo cannot be allowed to continue. 2.2 million people remain trapped, with 9 out of every 10 spending entire days without food. Gazans are experiencing unprecedented levels of starvation and thirst, while doctors lack even the most basic of medical supplies to treat the wounded and the growing threat of infection. What we need is access. Israel must stop blocking the entry of aid and allow life-saving assistance into the Gaza Strip.
The talks on aid come as more UN agencies continue dire warnings about the worsening humanitarian crisis in Gaza. The UN Children's Agency slams Israeli attacks, which have killed thousands of civilians, including children. The death toll mounts as most of Gaza's hospitals are no longer operating due to damage from the attacks and the lack of fuel and staff.
Truly, I'm furious. I'm furious that those with power shrug as the humanitarian nightmares unleashed on a million children. Alisa, I'm furious that Christmas is likely going to bring increased savagery in attacks as the world is distracted with its own, you know, love and goodwill. I'm furious that now we're at 5,000, 6,000, 7,000 children killed and they're becoming statistics and not stories. I'm furious at the, you know, hypocrisy is crushing empathy. And yeah, to a degree, I'm furious at myself for not being able to do more. The Gaza Strip remains the most dangerous place in the world to be a child. And day after day, that brutal reality is reinforced.
The World Health Organization, meanwhile, calls the situation in the Strip unconscionable.
The people in the hospitals, yes, they need everything. They need medical supplies, but what they ask for first is food and water, the very basics. They do not have them. One of my colleagues described people lying on the floor in severe pain, in agony, but they weren't asking for pain relief, they were asking for water. That it's beyond belief that the world is allowing this to continue. I haven't been there, but just what I'm seeing and hearing from my colleagues is something that it's unconscionable that the world allows this to continue.
Hamas rejects talks for another hostage prisoner swap deal with Israel, but it says it remains open to any initiative that would help end the war. The group insists negotiations will not happen under what it called Israel's genocidal war. It also slams the U.S. for its continued support of Israel.
For 74 days, the Israeli war machine has been destroying entire neighborhoods and civilian infrastructure, not to mention the mass killing of our people everywhere, including in their homes, in hospitals, or in shelters. We affirm our position of categorically rejecting to hold any form of negotiations over prisoners' exchange under the continuing Israeli genocidal war. We are, however, open to any initiatives that contributes to ending the aggression on our people and opening the crossing to bring in aid and provide the relief to our Palestinian people.
Israel's president earlier signaled the country is ready to enter another truce in order to recover more hostages held by Hamas. One of the Filipinos taken hostage by Hamas recounts his ordeal during his nearly 50 days in captivity. Jimmy Pacheco says he was among the hostages paraded in Gaza the moment captured on a viral video of him tied in the back seat of a pickup truck. He adds 15 of them were taken to a tunnel. He was grappling with bad bruises that he couldn't stand up for days. He also kept asking to be freed.
Ang sabi ko sa isang general nila kasi nakausap ko, bakit nyo kami dinala dito? Eh, mga Thailander at mga Pilipino kami. Isa lang yung sagot niya, it's a big mistake. Hindi na nagsalita. Hindi mo alam kung kailan ka mamamatay kasi talagang yanig yung tunnel eh, kapag ano eh, nagbubumbahan eh. Nung nasa tunnel kami, mga third week or fourth week, mga ganun na. Pag magdasal na ako noon, inahamon ko na rin yung Diyos eh. Kapag may pikot ko na to, ako sa kanya, sana wag mo na lang akong gisingin. Ganun-ganun na yung mga dasal ko noon. Para tapos na yung paghihirap ko.
Despite his ordeal, Pacheco says he still plans to return to Israel.